The question, how can you describe the difference between myalgic encephalomyelitis and fibromyalgia? They both share a lot of symptoms, are very often comorbid, and are treated in similar ways, but there are a few differences between the two illnesses. The main one to me is probably that ME just has a much wider range of symptoms, over 60 have been officially documented. Fibromyalgia, muscle and joint pain, heightened pain response to pressure, fatigue, usually quite disabling but less often leaves sufferers bedbound, vision problems, numbness, tingling, pins and needles, sleep problems, cognitive dysfunction, skin problems, myalgic encephalomyelitis, muscle, nerve and joint pain which is worsened by even mild physical activity, such as lifting an arm or rolling over in bed, and exposure to stimuli, such as light, sound, and movement. Fatigue, often severe, leaves 10-25% housebound or bedbound. Fevers and chills. Cognitive dysfunction, trouble understanding things one previously had a good knowledge of. Extreme susceptibility to colds and viruses. Sleep problems, severely disrupted circadian rhythms, can be as extreme as regularly spending 30-plus hours awake and 20-plus hours asleep. Muscle paralysis, spasms and twitches, seizures, breathing difficulties, disorientation, confusion and disequilibrium, extreme sensitivity to previously well-tolerated food, inability to maintain consciousness for more than short periods at a time, and many more. They share a few of the most significant symptoms, but there is a distinction. A huge part of ME is the fatigue and/or paralysis, and in fibromyalgia it is usually less about fatigue, and mostly muscle pain and pain. Response to touch/pressure instead. NB, as someone with both ME and fibromyalgia, I just to say that if you or someone you know has either of them, I'm really truly sorry. It's a horrible experience. Check out the link below for a guide on long-term remission or to join in with the community.